Thank you. join and reunify these two lovely peoples.
Amen.
Bobby and Rachell. To commit themselves to them. Amen. I don't want to say back because they are already committed. So I don't want to use the word back.
Amen.
But continue to be committed to one another.
Amen.
And continue to be faithful to their marriage vows.
Amen.
We are here to recommit and rejoin and reunify them and renewing of their vows. Amen. It's a wonderful and beautiful thing that you want to marry one another all over again.
Amen.
I got to make them laugh. Look at them serious. Looking over that hill like, you better behave yourself. Amen. But it's a wonderful thing. But now I charge you both that you'll continue to be committed to one another and continue to be committed to your wedding vows and continue to allow one another to be first in each other's lives, and to be the best friend among all the friends that you would have. The friend that sticks closer than a brother is a husband and a wife.
Amen.
Because it also is an example of Christ and the church.
Amen.
We know Christ is that brother that sticks closer. But when it comes to a husband and wife, you can't get any closer than as being an example of the church and Christ. Because as Christ put the church first, and even gave his life for it, same should the man put the woman first in his life to love her and cherish her. And she likewise with her husband. The same with him. So today this is a wonderful thing. Amen. A wonderful thing that you all will come to redo this all over again. Amen. For the second time. Amen. It's a wonderful thing. And I charge you all that y'all will continue to endeavor and strive. It's not easy all the time. I think you already experienced that. But it is possible that love can be without dissimulation.
Amen.
And love can be what it's supposed to be.
Amen.
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 Amen. I have charged you all, now we go to the marriage vow. You ask about saying that prayer. Bob, do you take this moment to be the wedded wife? And do you solemnly promise before God and these witnesses that you will love her, comfort her, honor and keep her in sickness and in health, and that forsaking all others for her alone, you will perform to her all the duties that a husband owes to his wife until God by death shall separate you? Rachell, do you take this man to be your wedded husband? And do you solemnly promise before God and these witness that you will love him, comfort him, honor and keep him in sickness and in health, and that forsaking all others for him alone, you will perform to him all the duties that a wife owes to her husband until God by death shall separate you? Okay. Since it is your desire to be recommitted together again, I want you to join your right hand. So I'm going to take this one. Repeat out to me these marriage vows. First. I, Bobby. You first.
I, Bobby.
Take thee, Rachell.
Take thee, Rachell.
To be my wedded wife.
To be my
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better or for worse.
For better or for worse.
For richer or for poorer.
For richer or for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
To death us do part.
To death us do part.
According to God's holy ordinance.
According to God's holy ordinance.
And thereto.
And thereto.
I apply thee my faith.
I apply thee my faith.
Rachell. I, Rachell.
I, Rachell.
Take thee body.
Take thee body.
To be my wedded wife.
Okay, Tyler.
I can't, don't worry about it. You start us, go ahead.
No, I have to joke in here.
Rich
or for poor.
For rich or poor.
In sickness, you had a problem with that. You had a problem with the rich, but with the poor part. In sickness and health, I said I was going to behave.
Yeah.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
To death us do part.
To death us do part.
According to God's holy ordinance.
God's
holy ordinance.
Holy ordinance.
And thereto.
Apply thee.
My faith.
My faith.
Rings, please. These wedding rings is an outward and physical sign of an inward and spiritual bond which unite two Lord hearts and in His love. And it's a continuation of y'all's commitment to one another and the endeavor to love one another and to cherish one another. It would always be a symbol to others that if they see these rings that y'all are united and you all committed to one another. Rachell, will you receive this ring from Bobby as a token of his affection and sincerity and fidelity towards you?
Yes.
And will you wear it as a symbol of your own affection, sincerity, and fidelity towards him?
Yes.
Bobby, will you receive this ring from Rachell as a token of her affection and sincerity and fidelity towards you? And will you wear it as a symbol of your own affection, sincerity, and fidelity towards her?
Yes.
You may place your rings on your finger. Okay, place his. Amen. all my earthly goods, I thee and thine.
With all my earthly goods.
I thee and thine.
I thee and thine.
Bobby, catch me. This ring I give thee.
This ring I give thee.
In token and pledge of our constant faith.
In token and pledge of our constant faith.
Abide in love.
Abide in love.
With this ring.
With this ring.
I thee wed.
I thee wed.
And with all my earthly goods.
With all of my earthly goods.
I thee and thine.
I thee and thine.
For as much as Bobby and Rachell have consented together and folded wedlock and have witnessed the same before God and these companies, as they have desired to recommit themselves to one another by the power and authority vested in me, once again I say you are husband and wife. May you kiss the bride. We ask everybody to bow your heads. Heavenly Father, we pray that you will bless this couple. Continue to be with them, God. Bless all their endeavors. Everything that they set their hearts and minds together in unity, Lord, we ask you to bring to pass. That what they pray about, Lord, we ask that you would do it for them. Father, Lord, you be with them through the thick and the thin, through the fire, through the water, through the ups and the downs, God. You will hold them together like glue. Let love, oh God, continue, oh God, to be the number one thing in this marriage and this relationship. And let them think on themselves before they think on one another before they think on themselves, oh God. Father, Lord, that they might put one another first. And they will always, God, be there for one another.
Amen.
Lord, now we ask that you will bless them and keep them. Make your face to shine upon them. Be gracious unto them and lift your countenance upon them. and give them your peace. By this we put your blessings upon you forevermore. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
I present to you once again.
All right.
Bobby and Rachell Brown.